Yeah. You want to go ahead and do that, or I'll go ahead and check to see if she had any dash cam. Hey, why don't you go ahead and tell your buddy to go ahead and move up with you? Go ahead and continue to drive. The guy in the red and black. Yep, stay right there, right there, right there. Hey, turn off the bikes for me, please. Guys, what are you guys doing?
Driving.
Alright. Looks like you guys were doing a little bit more than driving. Looks like you guys was recklessly driving. Guys probably didn't see me until last second, but I saw both of you guys coming up from Route 68 back there. Definitely high rate of speed, and one of you guys almost crashed into someone. Crashed into another vehicle. I have to look at my dash cam for that, but why don't you guys go ahead and do me a favor, go ahead and just hop off the bikes for me, please. And just go ahead and do me a favor, both of you guys just go ahead and just lean up against that that little rail right there. Alright, you guys got any ID? Identification? Alright, yeah, let me go ahead and get both of you guys ID, please. Alright, so one of them is both of them are definitely going to be getting citations. I'm not too sure about being placed on arrest, but as far as citation-wise, yes. Alright. Alright, just going to just hang tight. You guys don't have any weapons on you, do you?
No.
Nope? Okay. Alright, just going to just hang tight. Alright, so we're going to go ahead and look up both of their names, and then we can go ahead and start looking at the license plates. But one name is going to be Ricky Smith.
Warning,
armed. Alright, this person could be armed. Oh, unless I'm looking at the wrong individual. I believe it was the wrong individual, so let's actually go ahead and just type in the whole name. I was just being lazy. And just try to type in Ricky. Okay, he is considered armed. Alright, so this is the individual. Alright, let's look up his vehicle registrations. That's gonna be 21M. Okay, I got his license plate. His license plate is coming back called clean, valid. Let's look at his license. Alright, everything's gonna be pending, so it looks like he's been arrested before. I'm not too sure for what. Let's go and look at it. Possession of an illegal substance. Alright, so yeah, he's been around for sure. Let's go ahead and look up the other person's individual, as well, the other individual's information. And his name was going to be Jeff. My name is Jeff. That's, dude, that's the first thing that pops in my head every time I hit Jeff. Alright, he's been placed under arrest before. Vehicle information. What's his plate? His plate was going to be, what's that, 04? RK. Alright, everything's coming back valid on his side. So they're definitely going to be receiving citations today. So let's go ahead and actually talk to them. Alright guys, to get your information back. Alright, so here's what's going to happen today, okay? Usually, if I had a backup unit right with me right now, obviously I don't have that. both of you guys would be going to jail tonight. And I would personally place you guys in handcuffs and send you guys to jail tonight just because of the reckless driving. But unfortunately, I'm not going to go and do that. But I can't have you guys driving the bikes. So the bikes are going to get towed. You guys aren't going to get arrested. But just because of what I saw, the racing, high rate of speed, and I have to go ahead and review my dash cam. I haven't done that just yet. Looks like one of you guys even probably hit another vehicle along the way. So I'm definitely not going to go ahead and allow you guys to take off. So go ahead and do what you guys got to do as far as getting a taxi or Uber en route. I'll let you know when to do that. And you guys are going to get in citations as well. So, okay. So, like I said, you guys aren't going to jail, which I could be taking both of you guys in for on public endangerment as well, but I'm not going to do that. All right. All right, and I'll be right back. What? They probably didn't expect that. They probably didn't. He probably didn't realize I was gonna do that. Like, dude, you gotta pay some type of fucking consequence for that, dude. Some type of consequence for that. Like, that's on, you know, that's a mistake that they, you know. Shit, they're gonna have to fucking call the Uber. That's not my fault. That sucks. Sucks to suck, huh? Let's go ahead and give this guy, Jeff. Let's go ahead and start this record. Alright, so he is going to be arrested. Well, I said arrested for.
Yo, I don't think he knows. Go, man.
App? What did he say? Where the fuck did the other guy go? Dude, where's the other guy?
He just went to go. He just went to go. Just went to go use the page
run
over there.
Oh, dude, what are you doing across the highway? What type of stupid shit is that? Bro, you don't just sit there and cross a highway. Not in front of, especially not in front of a cop. That's why I said you're supposed to call it Uber, and I told you guys not to do that just yet. I will let you guys know when to. I said that. So next time just pay attention a little more. Yeah, but why, okay, so why are you all the way across the other highway? Why are you, that doesn't make sense, and I'm pretty sure you're wearing something completely different, so I don't know how the fuck that even happened. So make sure that doesn't happen again. And I'll be right back. Alright, fellas. Here goes your citation. Go ahead and take that. Make sure you guys sign at the bottom line for me, and let's go ahead and grab those keys from you guys, please. Thank you.
Do I have
to? What was that?
Do I have to give you the keys?
Yes, your car is being impounded at the time, so you can go ahead and pick that back up at the station when everything is processed and whatnot, so. Thank you. Alright, and your key, sir. Thank you. Alright, so like I said, I am cutting you guys a break, whether you know or not you guys see it. But you guys was doing some jank shit. So obviously you guys wanted some attention, and that attention was drawn to you, and You guys are lucky that I don't roll back my dash cam and see how fast you guys was going to begin with. So if you really want to sit here and talk, you guys were going way over 60. That's bullshit. I seen you guys coming down the whole entire halfway from all the way from the yellow jack all the way to where you got to me. Radar's gonna clock all of that. Come on, so don't argue with me. And you will, yeah, exactly. I will listen to your friend over there. So you guys are all good, like I said. I have the keys, and you guys are gonna have to call an Uber, taxi, anything like that. So you guys need any assistance with that?
Nah, I got my phone, it's fine.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm gonna call a taxi.
Alright.
I'm on it, it's fine.
Alright, when that taxi arrives, I'll go ahead and get your bikes towed. It's an unfortunate situation, but obviously, you know, just some unfortunate driving out there today.
It's an unfortunate.
It's unfortunate that you was driving over 60 miles per hour, opposite lane of traffic, speeding, racing. Yeah, I would just go ahead and get in that taxi and drive off. Have a good night.
Bye.
Let's not drive like that again. Okay, well, at least not get caught. He just got caught. That's what it is, man. Gonna get these bikes up out of here. Okay, I was gonna say, yeah, this definitely, he's not on a Conquer. I probably should have checked that corner, but I totally forgot. Oh, we just pulled this guy over, too. Hey, what's up, man?
Hello?
Yep, can you hear me? What's up, dude?
Hello?
Yeah, I can hear you, my bad. I muted the wrong person. But yeah, what's up?
So as I was back there on Joshua, or kind of heading towards Joshua, I saw this black Mustang turn right onto Algonquin Boulevard, and as he was turning, he was kind of sliding onto Algonquin.
No, so he drifted around the corner.
Yeah. And he slid, and then as I was putting my sirens on, he looked like he was about to run off, but as I kept putting my sirens on, he pulled over. And here we are.
Okay, and how fast do you think he was going?
Maybe around 15.
Okay. Alright, let's go ahead and check it out. Go ahead and take the driver's side, I'll take passenger.
Alright. Good evening, sir. I'm with the VCSO. Do you know why I pulled you over today?
Passenger, you want to go ahead and roll down your window for me, please?
I don't know why.
Back there on Joshua, I saw this car specifically, as it was turning on to Algonquin, you literally slid onto this road, or, you know, you kind of did like a drift onto this road, and I saw you do a drift kind of back there. You were sliding onto the road.
Oh, No, but I don't think I was. I think you might be seeing.
No, yes, I was. Yeah, I saw it. I was behind you the whole time.
Okay.
Anyway, can I get your license registration proof of insurance?
Yeah, I can get that for you.
Okay, so what's the name gonna be?
It's gonna be a Jeff Wonder.
Okay. Stay right here while I go read your information.
Sir, what is going on, man? This is our second time we met today, huh? What happened with leaving? I didn't think I was gonna run back into you.
Who are you talking to?
The person who I've only met before. You?
I'm guessing that's me then.
Yeah.
what do you mean? First, yeah. I get trespassed and then.
Yeah, because you're out here just doing stupid shit.
How am I doing stupid things? I just bought the motel and now I got trespassed, so how's that stupid?
Well, he just told me you drifted around the corner. Isn't that stupid shit?
I didn't drift around the corner though. He's seeing things, I could talk to you.
Oh, okay.
I remember you. You put me and my buddy over on motorcycles earlier.
Oh.
Yeah, that was.
You guys are still out here. I'm surprised. Well. Surprised I haven't ran into someone new yet.
We're best friends.
Best friends stay together. Yeah, I get it, but can't be doing stupid shit though. Then you know, when it comes down to receiving the consequences.
All we're trying to do is go down to LS Customs, and then we get harassed by you two.
So what do you mean harassed by you two? You like don't say harassed by you two. I'm doing my job, and so is he. And he saw you do something that was illegal.
How is he doing his job when he's lying about stuff?
What do you mean?
How's he doing his job when he's lying about stuff?
I don't think he's lying. I mean, he's a sworn officer, and I highly doubt he's gonna sit there and lie about that.
Well, if I get a ticket for something that he's lying for,
alright, sir. I'm just gonna let you off with the warning today. Just please be careful with you. Be careful on how your driving is. You know, you don't want any accidents to happen. You're trying to just keep everyone safe, you know? So, you got any questions for me?
No, I do not.
Alright, have a nice day.
Yeah, you.
Alright, take care, man.
You too.
Alright guys, so we're gonna go ahead and respond code 3 to a. Yeah, we're gonna be en route to I think a motor vehicle accident. I think that's what it is. Looks like there's a fucking mission coming up on my side too. That's weird because I usually turn all my missions off beforehand, but let's go ahead and head out there as fast as we can. Not too sure if the injuries or even what type of accident, but he just hit me on northbound police style. Okay. We're gonna be looking for what? A brown sedan. Just a U-tool over here, 107A. Is that the? Is that someone? I see a brown car over there. I'm not too sure if that's the actual sedan. What's going on over here, though? What the fuck is going on? Something's going on over here. Oh, he just got it. Okay, this is the individual. Now, what item 6, go ahead and show me. I'm going to be northbound on 13. I'm going to be near the U2. I'm going to be just past the U2. I'm going to be on the number 2 lane. Hey, what's going on, sir? How you doing? You okay? Hello?
Hey.
You okay?
Hey, babe. I don't know. I'm okay. I'm just a little banged up, but she I don't know if she's okay.
Alright, what happened?
She hit me. I was trying to wake her up. I was driving, she swerved and hit me. It made me hit the guardrail right there. She busted my truck, now my truck tries to stay open, but as of right now, I don't know what's going on with her. She's not responsive right now, but...
Okay, alright, in the meantime, why don't you just go and just hang tight over there? Is that your car?
Yeah, that's mine.
Okay, in the meantime, why don't you just go ahead and just hang tight over there, okay? Yeah, we'll go ahead and get all this sorted out.
Yeah, she hit me, so I don't know.
Alright, here, you want to go ahead and talk to him? I'm like, talk to him, try to get his side of the story. Get him out the street, and I'll take care of this over here. Just go to on scene 2 if you guys can. Alright, let's go ahead and, let's go ahead and check their pulse to see, see if they're conscious at this time. No, let's go ahead and, well, I don't know if the car door is even going to be open. Oh, it looks like the car door is open. Let's go ahead and use our gloves, though. I don't want to touch her. Let's go ahead and switch over. Crap. Hello, ma'am. Can you hear us? Hello? Can you move at all? Are you okay? Alright, so she has a low pulse. It's going to call EMS. I didn't really think we was going to get a pulse at all, so the way the vehicle is banged up, and just because of how his vehicle is all banged up, and oh my god, this car just get hit. This car definitely just got hit, because the car was not like that in the beginning.
Thank you.
All right, so we got EMS en route for her. All right, so I guess we're just stopping all traffic, I would assume. Why is there, I just tried to have the two lane. Okay, there we go. Someone's gonna have to move. Alright, what's going on with, what's going on with him? Nope, can you hear me?
Yeah.
Alright, yeah, what's up with him? What is he saying?
The woman in that car was texting me, that she veered into his lane and came up and hit him into the guardrail.
Okay. A 911 call. Well, we're definitely getting two different stories here. Two different stories saying, original 911 call said that he was erratic driving and driving at a high rate of speed, and it's matching the same vehicle description as that one that he's driving right there, which is a brown vehicle. So if he's saying something different and we're getting a 911 call saying that he was driving wild and whatnot, we just have to figure out exactly what's going on. But, let me go ahead and look at the YouTube. Let me go ahead and check the YouTube camera. And I'll go ahead and get her cleared away, because I'm pretty sure a tow arrived. What was that? Yeah. You want to go ahead and do that, or I'll go ahead and check to see if she had any dash cam. Alright. Yeah, I'm sorry, would you happen to have any dash cam?
No.
Okay.
No dash cam on me, but she did hit me. As you can tell, from my back, from the back of my car. I was driving on this lane, and,
Alright, so we're gonna RP that EMS did arrive. Unfortunately, I do have to drag outside the vehicle.
She veered off into my lane.
Just because she's an AI. But we're gonna just go ahead and park our car right here just to get it out of the way. And we can actually go ahead and move our car.
Do you want me to go check the YouTube camera?
No, I'll go ahead and take care of it. Stay with him.
Alright, I'll stay with him. I was trying to pull off my car, so I'm trying to
get it. It's unfortunate that we have to just drag the body out and leave the body like that, but hey, you know, it happens, and you know, we need to do it right now, so. Oh my god, what the fuck? You stupid bitch. What was that for? Did he not see me turning with my lights on? Now I need to go ahead and fix up my car, but we're gonna have to do that after. Hey, guys, don't mind me. I'm just checking the, I'm eating a piece of candy right now. Well, I have been eating a piece of candy for the last couple of minutes, so I've been eating it and probably been making weird noise, so don't mind that, and I do apologize if it you know, does happen. So looks like we got our CCTV footage right over here, so let's go ahead and let's take these fucking gloves off too. Totally forgot about that. Alright, so we're gonna just patiently wait for the CCTV footage to appear. Looks like they have a bunch of cameras that lead even towards the highway. So yeah, we can definitely see anything that pops up from here, from inside the parking lot to pretty much where that ambulance is right now. So we'll try to see if we can get what exactly what happened or what we can see beforehand. I'm trying to see where else do they have cameras at. Most likely definitely around the corner, probably around that side, I'm assuming. But as long as we can get something, because if they pass this direction, we'll definitely get street view of that car or any other vehicle as well. Alright, so it looks like the definitely looks like the brown van, well, the brown sedan, is definitely going to be the cause of the accident, the reason for the accident. So we're going to just further fast forward the video a little bit to see exactly where the crash is. All right, so it looks like the driver is going to be actually being placed under arrest. Not too sure exactly what happened there, but this driving very aggressive and reckless driving as well too. So him causing an accident on top of that is just, you know, that's just not good. And, you know, he did cause severe bodily harm, so, and someone did get transported to the hospital because of him. So, unfortunately, he is going to have to, he's going to have to get placed in handcuffs tonight. Alright, let's go ahead and try to use this breakdown lane as much as we can. Dude, why is he inside the car? Why is he inside the car?
He was sitting inside.
Yeah, but why is he driving the car, though? Did you not see him driving the car? Like, were we not watching him? Someone's in it, driving. Dude, what are you doing driving a car? Who told you to get back inside the car?
I was just moving there.
Yeah, you didn't have to move. Yeah, the car is totally fine, but we don't need you inside the vehicle after all of this, all right? I understand that. Okay, but yeah. Alright, just go ahead and just turn around for me, please. Can you go ahead and face your car for me, please? Can you go ahead and just turn the opposite way for me, please? Alright, sir, we're not gonna go ahead and do this. I'm not gonna go ahead and sit in debate. It's rather you're gonna sit in and turn around. We're gonna use force for you to resolve this. So I would turn around if I were you. Thank you. Alright, do you have anything on you that's gonna stick me, poke me, or harm me in any type of way? Alright, so I have handcuffs on you right now, okay? The reason why I have handcuffs on you, you can face me now. The reason why I have handcuffs on you is because I looked at the CCTV footage at the U2 and did my investigation that I need to do. And it looks like you were the cause of the accident. You were the reason why this accident did occur and did happen. It wasn't just a simple accident. It was due to your reckless driving, okay? I saw everything. You don't need to sit here and explain or sit here and say anything else. I'm not asking you anything. I already have what I needed to know. And you're going to be going to jail tonight just because of the great bodily harm that you caused to that woman due to your driving. Okay? And have you been smoking? Do you smoke at all?
What was that?
I said, do you smoke at all?
Uh, I mean, occasionally, but I mean, I haven't smoked for a while.
Okay, when was the last time you smoked?
I mean, like, I left the bar probably, or no, I actually left my house. I mean, I took, like two hits before I started driving. That was about it.
Today?
Today, yeah.
Okay. All right, well.
I went to my buddy's house.
All right, and are you, like, do you think you're intoxicated right now?
I mean, no.
No? You said you just took two hits. Like, how long ago was this? Well, I'm going to go ahead and read you your rights. I'm going to read your rights before we go ahead and go anywhere further with asking any questions, okay? You do have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be held against you in a court of law. You have the right to an attorney. If you cannot afford an attorney, one will be appointed to you. With those rights in mind, do you speak to me, yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so you said you smoked about 3 hours ago? That's the last time?
Yeah, 3 hours ago.
Okay. Yeah. Do you have any weed or any illegal narcotics inside the vehicle? Because the car is going to be getting searched.
Yeah,
if you want, you're going to just switch to your gloves, your blue ones, if you have them. You have a baggie, that's all you have inside there? A bag of what, exactly?
Yeah, like a bag of weed, I was about to go to my boy's house.
Alright, you wanna come back over here? When I come back over here to my car, we'll talk about it over here inside. Just go ahead and watch ahead when you get in. Alright, so you said just a bag, right? Just a bag of weed, nothing else in there.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and verify that. Same type for me, okay?
Okay.
Alright, what'd you get? Anything?
Yeah, there's a bag.
Okay, alright, well, at least we got the bag that we was looking for. If you could do that. I'm also going to go ahead and just charge him for the public endangerment as well, and I'm going to have to look in the penal code to see what I can do about him causing the bodily harm due to him already committing a crime too, so I'll double check that. But as of right now, I got him for public endangerment. He'll be going down for that. Possibly reckless driver as well, too. Might as well stack that. Well, we have to see if he's intoxicated. You said it was like about 3 hours ago, too. So, also have to figure that out. How much is inside the bag?
I haven't weighed it yet.
Okay. It doesn't really look like anything over the legal limit. So I guess that's fine. We can go ahead and actually take that in too. You know, just for evidence. See what we can do. He's possibly might be intoxicated, might not. I don't have my kit on me, so that's something I'll have to figure out at the station, but as far as right now, reckless dangerous and public endangerment. Okay. Alright, you want to go ahead and get a tow out here for the car, and I'll go ahead and transport him. Unless you want to transport him, and I'll call for a tow. How you want to do it? How do you want to do it? You want to transport him, and I'll stay here for the tow, or... actually, I'll transport him. Never mind. I'll take him. Alright, could you go ahead and just send me over that information as far as his name and stuff like that, the plate, so I can go ahead and fill out the arrest report after?
I believe the plate fell off. I didn't get his name.
There's no plate in the front? Okay. I'll go ahead and verify that. Thank you.
I think it fell on the front and back, but I don't know.
Alright. I'll go ahead and I'll take care of that. Thank you. I appreciate it. Alright, so he's going to be getting placed under arrest tonight for public endangerment and reckless driving. that's pretty much all I have for him right now. I do have to check the penal code after I drop him off to see exactly what else I can charge him with. But I would chop it up with him, I would talk to him, but he's actually on a phone call right now. This is actually my other directors, my assistant director here with me today. So I appreciate that I have him in game with me today for a little bit.
Make a phone call?
Yeah. You'll be able to make a phone call once you get back down to the, but once you get past the front desk and once you get all situated and stuff with booking and processing, yeah. No, unfortunately, I don't. That's going to be up to the judge. I just transport you and drop you off here, and what happens inside here is what happens with them. But, yeah, that's a whole different process, though, unfortunately. You know, you got to just make smarter decisions next time, and, you know, you probably wouldn't have been in or been in place in that situation. Yeah, that's fine, but you know, you gotta be cautious, especially when you're driving, you know.
Yeah.
You can kill somebody, hurt yourself, hurt them, so. Alright, go ahead and hop out, watch your head, sir. Alright, go ahead and step right into this bubble. Alright, I'm gonna go ahead and fingerprint and process you really quick. Go ahead and stand near that camera system right there for me, please. While I switch my gloves. Alright, gonna go ahead and take the cuffs off, alright? You're locked inside, so there's no escape, so don't try it.
Alrighty.
Alright, well, and with your right hand. What was that?
I'm not an aggressive guy, so you don't have to worry about that.
Alright, actually, you wanna go ahead and stand right here next to the phone, so I can go ahead and be easy for me. Alright, with your right hand, let me go ahead and get your right hand, please. Alright, with your left hand for me, please. You have a question in the text chat as well, too, from Leo on scene. Alright, so that's gonna be all set. So like I said, Deputy's gonna come ahead and take you inside, and he's gonna go ahead and finish booking and processing you. But booking is done, so he'll go ahead and, you know, give you sheets and.
Is this where I make my phone call? Do I use this phone?
No. You would actually wait until a deputy come get you. He's gonna, once I leave, another person is gonna come, and we're gonna just swap off. And he'll take you inside where you'll be. You know, you'll finish your processing from there.
All right.
Take care, and yeah, make better choices too next time.
Tell me pretty lies, look me in the face, tell me that you love me.